बीच में बात कर सकते हैं?
हाँ हाँ बिल्कुल कर सकते हैं, ये क्लासरूम है, कोई स्टूडियो पे तो चल नहीं रहा है कि आप बीच में बात नहीं कर सकते
हैं। सो द फर्स्ट टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टुडे इज द ओरिजिन ऑफ ओशन बेसिंस। व्हेनेवर वी टॉक अबाउट द ओशंस, सो हाउ मेनी ओशंस आर देयर, व्हाट आर दे, स्टडी का मतलब ये व्हिच इज दिस ओशन, अटलांटिक, ठीक है। This ocean?
Pacific.
So Pacific is the largest ocean. It covers this entire area. So we call this a Then Pacific and Indian Ocean through this region, yeah? सार्थक टू हियर एंड हियर तो क्या है सी देन इफ आई फोल्ड दिस मैप इट विल बी अ ग्लोब होगा ना सो दिस रीजन एंड दिस रीजन विल कम टुगेदर यस और नो वंस दे विल कम टुगेदर देन दिस आर्कटिक ओशन विल कनेक्टेड टू दिस रीजन आल्सो So, we are looking at the configuration of the earth where the oceans are connected to each other and such passages which connect two water bodies, they are known as passages which connect two water bodies. So, you can see here that when this water body and this water body are connected, they are dividing these two continents. Yeah? So, the passage, we can modify our statement that the passage of water which separates two water continents and joins two water bodies. What are they known as? Country. Channel. Really? They are called as straits. Straits. Okay? So, ye kaun sa strait? Which is this strait? Which is. There are several straits over here. This is straight. So we can see here that we have ये दोनों के बीच में here ये कौन सा straight है? ये क्या है? Yeah? So Arctic Ocean is being connected to the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans, and so all these passages they are known as ocean gateways or straits. Okay. The study of these straits and ocean gateways is important in the sense that they exert a major control on the transfer of water from one water body to another. And we all know that all the oceans have different properties. Let us start with the simplest of the properties. Which is the largest ocean? Which is the ocean with the oldest water? Pacific. Which ocean has maximum salinity? Atlantic Ocean. Okay. So, you have seen here that depending on the continent ocean geometry as well as the varying water properties, each ocean has different characteristics. Okay. So, imagine that if more saline water comes to lesser saline water, what it will do? It will increase the salinity. If warm water comes to the colder regions, it will increase the sea surface temperature. If colder water comes to warmer region, it will decrease the sea surface temperature. Then there are some water bodies which have higher nutrient content, they will increase the fertility. So likewise, okay. But going to these details of oceanography, the first and most important thing is to understand what are the processes that lead to the origin of ocean basins. We all know that the first ocean that was formed, probably they were not saline. Because when they started, they were very shallow oceans. It was a large single ocean body with an island kind of structure which started breaking up and took the shape of different continents. But probably they were not saline as today, because the intensity of weathering and erosion plus the rocks available for the weathering and erosion were not there as today. Are you getting my point, everybody? So, let us look at the configuration of the earth in terms of plate tectonics. Okay? Because, of course, it is the plate tectonics only which will give shape to the earth, and then it will give rise to different ocean basins. Understood? Alright. ये मैप को हम लोग बार बार देखेंगे, ठीक है। सो कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स इन इंट्रोडक्शन टू ओशन। विच इज द लार्जेस्ट टेक्टोनिक प्लेट? यूरेशियन प्लेट। और कोई आंसर देना चाहते हैं? यूरेशियन प्लेट। एनी एनीबडी एल्स वुड लाइक टू गिव द आंसर? लेट अस सी द मैप ऑफ अब विच प्लेट इज द लार्जेस्ट प्लेट। Pacific plate. So, if we look at the plate, tectonic plate configuration on the Earth, then you will come to realize that the shape of the continents does not exactly match the plates. जो continent का shape है, ये जरूरी नहीं है कि plates का shape वही हो। जैसे simple सा example देखिए, ये इंडिया का कॉन्टिनेंट देखिए, लैंड पोर्शन बट द इंडियन प्लेट ऐसा है, इट्स मच लार्जर बिकॉज इट हैज बोथ द पार्ट्स। कौन कौन से? द कॉन्टिनेंटल पार्ट एज वेल एज द ओशन पार्ट। सो इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट द प्लेट्स विल हैव सेम कॉन्फिगरेशन एज दैट ऑफ द लैंड मास। नाउ लेट अस लुक एट द मेजर प्लेट्स। सो यू ऑल नो दैट द प्लेट बेस्ड ऑन देयर कंपोजिशन ऑफ टू टाइप्स, the continental plates and the oceanic plates. The continental plates are silicic, they are granitic in nature, while the oceanic plates, they are mafic or basaltic in nature. Therefore, the oceanic plates are heavier. And since they are heavier, we have continents higher and oceans lower. Now, if we look at these plate, tectonic plates of the earth and the their configuration and the boundaries, then you all know it that there are three kind of plate margins: the convergent plate margin, the divergent plate margin, and the transverse fault margin. So, in other words, we can say that the convergent plate margins are the destructive plate margins, because when two plates collide, the plates they break, either they subduct or they give rise to folded mountain plates, fold belts. The divergent plate margin is called as the constructive plate margin. So if two oceanic plates they go away from each other, construction of new ocean flow starts to happen. Okay. What about the separation of two continental plates? Rift valleys are formed. Okay. Then the transform fault margin is called as the conservative plate margin. Best example that we see about the transform fault margin is the San Andreas fault. Okay, so if you see here, you can see how either the two plates they go away from each other or they converge. So if we look at the present day scenario, we can see here that the Pacific plate is colliding with the Australian plate, while the Indo-Australian plate and the African plate, you know, they are going away from each other, diverging. See this, the formation of Himalayas, the Eurasian plate and the Indian plate, they collided. They converge. Then look at this one, Antarctic plate and Australian plate, divergent margin. So it has been seen that the formation of the ocean floor is majorly a result of divergence. Okay.
Sir, which is the fastest moving plate?
Can you tell me which is the fastest moving plate? What is at what rate the plates they move? Present. So, if these questions come to your mind, try to find the answers to it. Fastest moving plate, tell me tomorrow. There are a few smaller plates also. The Nazca plate, Cocos plate, Caribbean plate, smaller plates are there. Okay. So what happens when these plates move and what is the driving force? You all know, what is the driving force of the plate motion? Convection. Convection is a magnet, okay? So let us go ahead and see, these are what characteristic of plate boundaries, wherein if it is a divergent plate motion, you will get a mid-oceanic ridge. Mid-oceanic ridge, ridge is a uplifted or higher elevated surface. So here you will be finding ocean ridges. Okay, example mid-Atlantic ridge. We will come to that back again. Subduction zones. So if it is a convergent ocean-ocean collision, okay, so relative plate motion in the subduction zone will definitely be convergent motion, ocean-ocean collision. We have the formation of deep sea trench and volcanic ground. Okay, so Aleutian Islands. Look at this. What are these? Here, the this you don't know what is that? That the Pacific Ring of Fire. They are Aleutian Islands only. Okay. Ocean continent collision. Again, deep sea trench and volcanic rock and these mountains. Look at this. The continent and ocean collision gives rise to volcanic mountain chains and these given. So how have they formed? As in the Pacific, the Pacific plate had subducted beneath the South American plate. To be more specific, you can say Nazca plate subducted beneath the South American. South American plate is a continental plate, Nazca plate is a oceanic plate. So the formation of volcanic mountain belts, it takes place. What about the divergence of two continental plates? Continental plate divergence. So when continent plates they diverge, we get the example of formation of rift valleys. Rift valleys. Okay? And these rift valleys, example, East African rift valley. So very recently I came across a news on the internet where the land mass in Africa was spreading. I'll send you that video also in your WhatsApp group. It's a very good example of the divergence or formation of these plates. Okay. All right. So when we
YouTube dikhaya.
All right. Now, when these plate motions they take place, what happens? We just saw how these features get formed. So if we look at, let us say this is one plate. Okay, this is a oceanic plate. Moving this way. And this. Ocean-ocean collision. The faster moving plate will definitely subtract because they have almost similar density. So the faster moving plate, it starts to subtract. So when this subduction takes place here, this zone where this plate starts going down, this is called as subduction zone. While this plate, this is the subducting plate, this is the overriding plate. So here, what do we get? We get these deep sea trenches and we get a volcanic arc. The second one is here. But if this plate was a continental plate, then what would happen? We will get, so what happens in this way? So if this plate goes down and this is the overriding plate. So what it does, it applies friction over here, and these plates, as they go down towards the mantle, they start to melt. Okay, into the heat. So we get, so if this is a continental plate over here, we get these plumes rising up, and then they give rise to volcanic mountains. So volcanic mountain chain is normally that of the subduction. So what's my idea? Based on these plate motions and movements, several processes have been given, and we have come to know about the formation of these ocean basins. So for example, if we look at the Atlantic Ocean configuration, does someone have a laptop here? Can you see it also?
If you look at the Western Pacific and Indian Ocean in between,
सी देयर आर सेवरल सीज हां सुलु सी साउथ चाइना सी सेरम सी मलुका सी
सो व्हेन वी कॉल दैट मोस्ट स्ट्रेट्स कैन वी कॉल देम सीज
दे आर सीज द स्ट्रेट्स दे यू नो दोस स्ट्रेट्स आर एक्चुअली यू नो काइंड ऑफ नैरो वाटर बॉडीज सीज आर विद ओपन अब जैसे आप देखोगे इधर मेडिटेरेनियन सीज तरफ Here we have this Mediterranean Sea, and now the Mediterranean Sea is connected to the Atlantic Ocean by this strait, known as the Strait of Gibraltar. So it's a very fine, very smaller water body. Seas are vast, and oceans are bigger. So it's the dimension and amount of water also. Okay, Caspian Sea. What is Caspian Sea? सुना है ना कैस्पियन सी का व्हाट इज इट इज इट अ सी इट्स अ लेक बट इट्स वेरी बिग इन साइज एंड इट इज यू नो बाउंडेड ऑन ऑल साइड्स सो ऑफ कोर्स देयर आर सीज व्हिच आर पेरी प्लेटोनिक बेसिस इंट्रा प्लेटोनिक सो यू कैन यू नो यूज दीज टर्म्स To define the size. Okay. All right. Now, if you look at this ocean, ये क्या है इधर? Himalayas. How are Himalayas formed? Collision of. So it was a convergent ocean again. So on this basis, we get to study the Wilson cycle. What is Wilson cycle? Wilson gave a series of events which tell us about the various stages of formation of these geomorphic features based on the great motions. Wilson cycle. When we look at the Wilson cycle and stages, you will very easily understand why they are called so. Okay? So the first one, the first stage. Embryonic stage just started. So all these features which I have just told you, आपको क्या लगता है? Which of these features is embryonic? Embryonic stage of this cycle. Embryonic. East African Rift Valley. East African Rift Valley. Atlantic Ocean.